In childhood, neurons are forming important connections, and existing connections are strengthened. Children, once viewed as empty vessels, are competent and curious, primed to explore and learn through play. We asked primary teachers, what does play mean to you? So, what is play exactly? Choice allows students to take ownership of their learning. If your students are accustomed to a more structured environment, we'll show how to gradually incorporate student choice into your classroom. Play is fun, and an emotional connection makes for long-lasting learning. Play is process-oriented. Have you ever entered the state of flow, becoming deeply immersed in an activity? Encourage students to enter the zone with satisfying learning opportunities with just enough challenge and large blocks of time to become fully engaged. An intentional play-based curriculum supports a growth mindset and promotes learning across domains. The educational value of play is sometimes underestimated. What are some common misconceptions about play?
We hear this all the time in our children's play area. People ask, where's the science?
What does science look like? We ask the internet. Science is more than a body of knowledge or chalk on a blackboard. It's a process. The process of science includes behaviors like sorting and classifying. Weighing and measuring. And active experimentation. Science can be playful, and play-based experimentation is research. A quick internet search brings up thousands of picture-perfect craft activities that require little creativity from students. What's wrong with this picture? The educator seems to be doing most of the work. A process-oriented art activity honors students' expression with less emphasis on an attractive finished product.
Giving students choice and ownership over their learning doesn't mean my classroom looks like this.
If we imagine classroom structure on a continuum, a playful classroom is neither didactic or laissez-faire. It's enriched by just the right amount of structure and support. The educator's role may be different, but it is no less active. It may involve setting the environment for play, supporting metacognition, and documenting student learning.
How can we do it? What do you think? You've got toothpicks.
In a playful classroom, the educator responds to student curiosity. An inquiry stance is like the mindset of a scientist. The teacher is actively questioning, wondering, and co-learning with their students. Are you interested in implementing a play-based approach but don't know where to start? Tune into the next video to learn more about how to integrate play into your classroom.